Gentlemen, do you miss me? Do you miss me? I think that the boys last week absolutely crushed it. I love last week's vlog, but this one is big number. What is it, 120? One? Are we at 120? Holy mother of Tiege Hanley. That's incredible. Guys, welcome back to the Starting a Business, Building a Brand vlog. This one, like we said, is 120, but 119 was special. Last week, you saw the boys at HQ. They took over and did an incredible job. It was so cool just to see them sort of rocking and rolling, and I loved that vlog. I laughed it, and I smiled the entire time, but I'm back. If you missed me, your boy Alpha is in the house. And last week, it has been one of the most exhausting past, like, I guess it's been like 8 days, right? Because last Monday, Antonio came into town in preparation for the conference. And then he stayed all week. My buddy Ryan Masters also came in. And so I had house guests pretty much for the past like 8 days. And I am such a creature of habit that I need schedule. I need regimen. I need to know what I'm doing at exactly the specific time that I'm doing it. And so having people here interrupting sort of my world and my routine was very difficult, but it was all worth it. I'm still picking up the pieces, but the conference, my God, the conference. Man, for those of you who were there, you know how spectacular and amazing it was. We sold it out. There were over 400 people there. The guy, like, and here's the, okay, so day one is all about business, and we had some incredible business people. Kelly was on a panel. I led a few panels, and it was a lot of fun. It was really cool to see, just, you know, to see, hear some of the stories of some of these entrepreneurs that come, because we have like 8 or 9 brands that set up tables around the perimeter of the place. And these are brands: Chassis, Anson Belt, Tiege Hanley, Desmalchi. They do like Dazzle Pro and Spinbrush, Tanny Underwear, like all of the who's who. Oh, Vincero Watch was there. Like all these brands that you hear me and Jose and Antonio and all these guys promoting and talking about, they're here at this conference. And we'll talk more about them and why it's so cool to have them there and why it's so inspirational to talk to them in a second. But it's really cool to hear their stories, because all of them are just like us, right? They're small business owners. They're people that had 9-to-5 jobs that decided they wanted to do something different. And they had an idea, and they weren't too scared to not, I should say, they were strong enough, they were brave enough to take a chance. Because in business, it's always risky, right? You're always going to have 2,700 reasons over here on this side why you shouldn't try something. Safety, family, security, you've got a good job with a pension plan. You've got all these reasons, all these people over here telling you you shouldn't, you can't, you won't, you don't even try it. And on this hand, the list to do it is much smaller. But the number one thing that you need to remember, and that's strongest over here, is the desire to do something different and to try something. And all these people were brave enough. They grabbed themselves by the well-moisturized nuts and said, yes, I'm going for it despite the uncertainty. Because here's the thing, the reality is this: it's never going to be the most perfect time. All the ducks are never going to be in the row. And if you're somebody sitting out there, see how fired up I am from this conference? If you're somebody sitting out there right now waiting for perfection and the perfect timing and all of the universes and planets and stars to be aligned, you're never going to do it, ever, period. You got to do it. You've got to take calculated risks, but you've got to do it. And you've got to put in the work. Nothing's easy. Every single entrepreneur that was up on this panel has had struggles, has had hardships, has, you know, taken money off credit cards to pay bills. Like, it's real. The struggle is real, but the upside is so incredibly sweet. And it was amazing to see these guys and hear their stories. Day two is all about personal development. We had great panels. We had all the YouTubers, right? Let me just run down a list of some of the guys you might know of. Alex Costa, Brett Maverick, Based Zeus, the guy who's sort of in charge of Based Zeus, which is a really fun channel. Jose Zuniga was there, Real Men Real Style, Jeremy Fragrance, Emil and Rasmus from Slick Hair TV. We had Charlie from Charisma on Command. I'm thinking all these people. We had just so many incredible, the OG, I forget his name, but he's like the style OG, he was there. We had a fantastic Eric from Beard Brand, the guy who was on Shark Tank, who's become a really good friend. Just all these crazy successful, you know, YouTubers and personalities. But we also had some guys that just, you know, were very inspirational and had some very good perspective on how to maximize and how to get more out of life and how to quiet those voices of uncertainty. But then the other thing that we had was hundreds of amazing men that just showed up because they wanted to, you know, hang out, they wanted to learn, they wanted to shake hands, they wanted to come up to me and tell me, not all of them, but they wanted to come up to me and some of them just wanted to shake my hand. Like, and that's the thing that I'm getting chills now talking about it still, even like a week after the fact. That's the thing, like people ask me like, oh, are you tired from the conference? You're up, you're working, you're running around, you're saying hi, you're shaking hands, kissing babies. It's not hard physically, it's hard emotionally for me. Because you don't realize how, and I'll try not to get choked up here. You don't realize, I guess, like sitting in my office, doing videos, seeing comments like, hey, good job. You know, I get emails from people telling me, you know, that I've helped them or whatever. But when you have somebody, a grown-ass man, you know, who has traveled hundreds of miles, who's sitting across from you, who just, you know, pulls you to the side and wants to tell you how you've changed their life and how you've helped them and how, you know, you've done some things for them. Like, it's just, it's really powerful. And doing this, and when I started this YouTube channel, I never in a million years would have guessed that I could have had an impact on anybody the way that it looks like I have to some degree. And so it's really emotional for me. Like, because like these guys are sitting here like crying, I'm crying. And, you know, so that's, I guess, the hardest thing for me is just emotionally dealing with all the kindness and, you know, the well wishes and all that good stuff. And so, not to mention, you know, it's super exciting and it's really cool. And so it's over for another year. We already have the dates. If you guys are interested, February 22nd and 23rd of 2019. It's going to be here before you know it. We've already sold like 200 of the 400 tickets to the people that were there. We sent an email out and said, yo, if you want them, grab your tickets. Prices are going to be increasing a little bit and we're obviously going to be selling out. And so if you're interested, make sure you go to the menfluentialconference.com website and see what's up, because we're going to sell out probably in the next few months. And it's like, it's that good. And I hope you can join me. But I wanted to talk now about products and brands, because that was actually, I was talking to Josh before I started shooting this today. And I said, you know, hey, I'm thinking about talking a little bit about the conference. Like, oh, and that's the crazy thing. There were so many dudes who came up to the Tiege Hanley booth and were like, because we had a booth there. And we're just like, I'm using skincare, and they were all excited. We had like 16-year-old kids coming up and like, hey, I'm using Tiege Hanley. I'm like, my mind almost exploded when I saw these 16-year-old dudes who are just like so fresh-faced, looking incredible, using skincare. I was envious. I was so jealous of them, because that's one of the things. If you start now, if you start, like if I could have started when I was a teen, I would look like I'm 22 right now. Unfortunately, I didn't start until I was in my like late 20s, 30s. But it's never too late to start. And you can definitely undo a lot of damage. But starting young, seeing these young dudes was incredible. But I want to talk a little bit about, and I guess the business lesson, there might be a few business lessons already in this video, is about the selection process that goes into working with a brand as an influencer. Working with an influencer, or working with a company, working with a brand, when I am approached, and this is something that I've told you guys before, but you may or may not believe me. For every one brand that I promote, every one company, I turn down 10. They come, they got money, but when I get the product, I look at it and I try it, I use it, I look at it, I feel it. and if it doesn't meet my standard. Like, because here's the thing you have to realize, and something that I realized a long time ago, is that when I promote something, I've got to be 100% behind something. It's not good enough just to kind of like it, or nah, it's all right, you know, why not? No, I've got to love the product, because it's my reputation and it's my credibility, and that is the number one thing that I've got and I have to maintain. And I turn down a ton of money because that credibility is not for sale. The other thing that needs to be in place is the back end for these companies. Logistics. Are they able to fulfill the products? Are they going to be able to handle like customer service issues? Because if not, then guess what? I get the emails, and that's the thing that a lot of people don't realize, is that when I promote a product and it breaks on somebody, or I promote a product and they get a tailored shirt that doesn't fit right, they might reach out to the brands, but you know who else they're sending emails to? Me. And so it's something where I need to be sure that the customer service, that the fulfillment, that the quality is good enough in order to meet my standards and my customer standards. Because if I recommend something that's crap, and like all these people are like, yo, this is crappy, it's my credibility at the end of the day. The other thing that I look at is the quality of the people running the brand and the business. Because at this stage of the game, I have met some really shitty people that have some really great brands. And you know what? I don't promote them. Because at this stage in my career, and the fact that I've set up this agency, Menfluential Media, it's a company that I started with my best friend Terry from high school, to sell advertising for me, to also sell advertising for all these guys. That's why you see, you know, all these guys like Baze Zeus and Brett Maverick and Alex Costa and Teaching Men's Fashion and Real Men Real Day. You see the same promotions or the same products being promoted by all these guys. And the reason is because my agency, you know, we get the deals and we help facilitate and work those relationships, and we take a commission on these other guys doing promotions for these brands. But the beautiful thing about creating this sort of this Menfluential Media company is that we have a collective and a collection of brands and companies that like I could, if I could upload 20 videos a week, I could fill 20 videos a week in terms of promoted content. And so I've gotten to a point where I can be incredibly selective with who I promote and who I do business with. And so, you know, all things being equal, I want to work with people that believe in me, that have great people behind the scenes running the company, and that are good dudes. And that's the thing that this conference, and when you attend, you realize. And something that Josh brought to my attention, he's like, I gotta tell you, I think it's amazing to actually be able to talk to these brands and these companies and hear these stories. Like Anson Belt, right? You know I love Anson Belt. You know I promote Anson Belt every chance I get. Well, the story behind Anson Belt is so special. They've been around for years, but it was 2 years ago that we started promoting them, and they struggled. They did like, I don't know, I think it was like $100,000 in sales, like up until the year before we started promoting them. And since then, their business has just astronomically taken off. And so much so that the owner came up to me, David, every year, but this year was crazy. He came up to me and he's like, I just want you to know that you've changed my life. You've changed my family's life. His wife now can stay home with the children. Like he hired his best friend from high school to come into the business and to help work. I mean, it's stuff like that. And I get chills hearing these stories. Adam from Tanny Underwear, another story. It's just an incredible, you know, they were doing like nothing before I started promoting them. And now they've got a business and they're expanding. Chassis, they were just starting when we got into the game. And now they're expanding into Asia, into Europe. And they're growing their business. And the guy, but that's the thing I want you to understand. Alex DeSmalchi from Dazzle Pro and Spinbrush and Vita Goods. And these guys are so incredible. They're great dudes who I just love to death, and it is a pleasure, it is an honor, and it changes the game, it changes the dynamics. Like, I love Vincero watches before, right? I think they're incredible. The two owners for Vincero, the two main owners, they came to the conference. They didn't have a booth. They came to shake my hand and to shake all the other influencers' hands and to shake the hands of the customers. You can't even imagine how many Vincero watches were walking around and Thursday boots and all these different companies and products that we promote. They're crazy high quality, and the guys are just the owners. It's not just some faceless brand that you're buying. It's a relationship. And for me, at this stage of my career and the game, it ultimately is about relationships and doing work and being with people that are just awesome. And it was really cool to see, and it was really cool for everybody that has bought their products to actually meet the guy behind the company. And it was just special. And so, you know, I guess, I don't know. I don't know if there's a business lesson in there or not, or just a life lesson that, you know, life is about relationships. Business is about relationships. At the end of the day, if you've got the best, most amazing product and you're a crappy person, I don't want anything to do with you. I don't care how much money you make. It doesn't matter. I want to help the company that has good people, great products, and that believe in me. And so, you know, it was cool to be able to once again just hang out with some of those companies and some of those brands. And so it was awesome. It was absolutely awesome. And I say it every year, but this conference is literally, it's life-changing. It's life-changing for a lot of reasons. And if you can get there next year, please do. I mean, Tiege was there in full force and definitely kissing babies and shaking hands. And it was really cool to see the guys sort of in the world, because all these people have been, all these customers and all these other influencers have done promotions. I mean, same sort of thing. They've done promotions for Tiege. Now they get to meet Rob, they get to meet Kelly, they get to meet Josh and actually shake hands and let them tell them, the influencer, how much they've helped and changed our lives. And so all around, it's just a really special event and special time for me right now. And so it was really cool. And I think that's where I'd like to leave it. Next week, I want to give you some updates. We've got lots of stuff happening. Acne updates, the customer surveys and feedback. It's been in customers' hands and the feedback has been ridiculous. I want to talk more specifically about acne because there are some people that don't like it. And, you know, there's the decision of, okay, you know, if this percentage of people are saying that it didn't work for them or they don't like it, do we move forward? When this percentage is saying that it's awesome, that it's good, you know, talk a little bit about that mechanism, because there's a point at which you know that you're never satisfying everybody. You're never going to have 100% consensus that this is the best acne treatment in the history of acne. And so dealing with that, going through the numbers, we've got all the data. And I want to share that with you next week. Also, down in the comments, business questions. Let us know. If you've got something that you think is incredible or a question that you want me to answer, let's hear it, boys, because we're ready to rock. I'm going to leave it there. You're incredible. I'm still tired and trying to catch up, but you, I missed you. I missed this. And you can probably tell by my energy today. I'm up, but I'm definitely tired and catching up. Guys, we love you more. Say it with me. Ready? On three. Then our double monk strap shoes. Guys, I'll see you next week.